Nieves Navarro was born on November 10, 1938 in Almería, Andalucía, Spain as Nieves Navarro García. She is an actress, known for Death Walks on High Heels, 1971, Death Walks at Midnight, 1972, and The Forbidden Photos of a Lady Above Suspicion, 1970. She was previously married to Luciano Ercoli. She began her career as a film actress in Italy alongside Toto in the Toto of Arabia parody Toto of Arabia, 1965, a Spanish-Italian co-production, in which she played Doris, a beautiful spy in the service of the British SIS, who charms the Sheik of Kuwait Ali el Buzur, Fernando Sancho, and allows Toto to use her to drive the 100 wives of Sheik jealous. These are my top 10 Nieves Navarro movies. At number 10. The Big Gundown, 1966. When Jonathan Corbett, Lee Van Cleef, in a famous scene from Lari Sa dei Conti, The Big Gundown, Sergio Salima, 1966, places three bullets on a log for three bandits who are chasing him, we can immediately guess the outcome. But this is not a sort of bravado move, a manifestation of superior dexterity or an act of mockery. Rather, this is how the outstanding character of Corbett seeks justice, and it is what will determine his disposition for the rest of the movie, the idea that everyone deserves a chance. At number 9. Death Carries a Cane, 1973. Keddie, a photographer living in Rome, accidentally witnesses the murder of a young woman at the hands of a razor-wielding black-gloved killer. Keddie and her fiancé, Alberto, go to the police, only to learn that two other witnesses to the crime have been slashed to death. At number 8. Light the Fuse, Sartana is Coming, 1970. The fourth and last Sartana movie with Garko, and no doubt the most crack-brained of them all. Sartana is equipped with a new array of weapons and gadgets, including a miniature robot in the form of a totem, called Alfie, who can be programmed to kill. Sartana is looking for half a million of gold and $2 million of counterfeit money, embezzled by a former friend called Granville Full, Grand Full for short. Grand Full has been arrested, so Sartana hands himself over at the state prison in order to spring his old pal from jail. At number 7. Il Giudice La Minorenne, 1974. Milan. Marco Serra, a middle-aged judge, lives with his wife Laura and teenage daughter Morella. The man is dealing with a case of sexual assault by a certain Mariani, a plumber, about Annetta Rossi, an underage girl. The plumber accused of the rape, however, defends himself by stating that he did not take the initiative at all, but claims that it was the girl who explicitly provoked him, then demanding a large sum of money in exchange for the service. Upon his refusal, the little girl would then have denounced him to take revenge. Judge Serra remains incredulous and disgusted. At number 6. All the Colors of the Dark, 1972. This is the basic kernel of All the Colors of the Dark. Like in Rosemary's Baby, we basically follow Jane around as she loses her grip on sanity. She counsels a psychologist, George Rigaud, and her sister, Nieves Navarro, both of whom ensure her that she isn't crazy, despite the fact that she's being stalked by a deranged-looking guy with piercingly blue eyes. He hunts her down across various locations, which leads to some dizzying, harrowing chase sequences where Martino really channels Polanski. The apartment building interior, particularly the elevator and staircase, is turned into an inescapable kaleidoscope of terror. At number 5. La Foto Proibita di una Signora per Bene, 1970. Minu is a wealthy housewife who yearns for the attention of her husband Peter. However, Peter is frequently busy at work and is rarely at home. Minu is out one night when she is attacked by a strange man who cuts open her clothes and warns her that her husband is a killer. Minu ignores what she has been told until she finds that a man indebted to Peter has been found dead. She receives a telephone call from her attacker, who plays a tape recording of Peter discussing the murders. The attacker tells Minu that he will go public with this evidence if she does not come to his house. When she is there, he further blackmails her into sleeping with him. At number 4. Orgasmo Nero, 1980. On the small island of Locandola, lost in the Caribbean Sea, Paul, an ethnologist, studies the customs of a tribe. He devotes most of his time to his work as an anthropologist, to the detriment of his wife Helene, who feels neglected. In addition to an unfulfilled libido, Helene has fertility problems, compromising the fact that she can get pregnant despite the pressure of her husband, who would like to become a father. When she arrives on the island, she wants to make love with him to spice up their sad sex life. At number 3. Death Walks at Midnight, 1972. Valentina, a beautiful fashion model, takes an experimental drug as part of a scientific experiment. While influenced by the drug, Valentina has a vision of a young woman being brutally murdered with a viciously spiked glove. It turns out that a woman was killed in exactly the same way not long ago, and soon Valentina finds herself stalked by the same killer. At number 2. Death Walks on High Heels, 1971. Exotic dancer Nicole finds herself terrorized by a black-clad assailant determined on procuring her murdered father's stolen gems. Fleeing Paris in hopes of evading her knife-wielding pursuer, Nicole arrives in England, only to discover that death stalks her at every corner. At number 1. The Family Vice, 1975. Giosu, a noble industrialist of the spaghetti of the Venetian province, is about to die and his half-sister, Magda, his wife, Ines, and daughter, Susie, the result of an old flirtation of 20 years before, all try to grab the huge inheritance, triggering a war made exclusively of low blows.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching. Please stay tuned for more videos and don't forget to subscribe and share. Enjoy.